Guten Tag und willkommen zu Beer Goggles Reviews. Welcome. Hello everyone. Welcome to Beer Goggles Reviews with me, Terry Kay. We've got a German one, as you probably guessed from my very terrible bad German, you know, but look, I do make an effort, you know. I always think I've gone off again, you know. I ain't even started the beer yet. I'll show you the beer first. Hovel's Original. And this is in the style of Altbier. Altbier is old beer. It's beer in like the old style, the old German style. You know, it's an ale that is that is warm fermented and is then kind of cold matured, bit like a lager, you know. So that's what it is. That's kind of the you know, the ghost. We've got one in frightening little tops. Now, what was I saying? Yes. I kind of think sometimes that the Brits and that, we go abroad and we go to all sorts of different nations, and we never learn the languages, you know. And we're the first people to go, oh, people come over and don't even learn the language. And we sometimes buy villas and whatever else in different countries, and we get very cross with them when they don't learn our language. It's like, why haven't you got our newspapers? And well, I can't understand all this. You're supposed to learn the language. At least try it out. You know, I'm trying to learn Italian, I'm trying to learn German and whatever else, you know. It's funny. Different languages. I love the sound of Italian. I just love it. I love it. I think it's a beautiful language, a really beautiful language. But funny enough, it's like German seems to fit more with our English kind of grammatic forms and that, and you know, the way we lay language out, our structure and everything. It seems kind of more logical to us. And now the British language or English language is a kind of a bastardised language of loads of different languages. So you got a bit of Germanic, a bit of Latin, a bit of all sorts. But instead of saying if you look at our old language, I've gone off enough, I'm sorry. our old language is the old English language. It's very kind of similar to the German layout, you know. I'll explain later. I'm kind of going off the ring. I'm going to break the little seal thing here, just so that pops up. There's the little seal thing. I kind of love these because you can use them for home brewing and whatever else. But for some reason, they always frighten me because I pop them and they're all over the place. So I don't like that for a start. Oh, there you go. All nice. Funny, I mean, with that guard thing, you'd think it was safer. But I feel I can control a cork with that. I'm like, where's it going to go? But luckily, it ain't gone everywhere. So we're, this was originally Hovel's original bitter beer. Or bitter beer original. Original bitter beer, I think it was. It's been going since 1893. So let's pour this and see what we get. long necks, so it's going to go glock, 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 glock. So if there is any yeast going on in there, it's going to kind of shake up a bit easy. A bit, glock, glock. It's like trying to drink a yard of ale. And I'm going to just lift it and, whoa, I've helped it too much to a head. It was a bit flat, so I've helped it to a bit of an head, and now it's gone poof. That's a weird one, that, because I was pouring it gentle down the glass, and it was like flat. I went, lift it a little bit, went, and it went poof. That'll die down, though, eventually. Kind of looks meringue-y, like the E405 heads. It's not smelling like that though. I wonder if this is brewed to Ryan Heitzkebot. Can't see it on here. There's a lot of German that have trouble speaking. But it's... It brewed with a herb called fine herb rot gold. So that's a red gold fine herb, which is an adjunct in there. So if we get anything, we're going to get that on it. It's kind of smelling like an half decent lager, but a kind of tasty one, a tasty one. But it's got like as dark as it is. It's got kind of lager nose on it, like lager herbs and things like that. Lager hops, I should say. Getting a tiny little clovey note in the background, maybe a fennel sort of note as well. Something a little bit distant in there, and maybe even coriander. Good lord, there's something out of an Army and Navy suite in there. That must be that rot, that fine herb rot gold. Because it's very strange, like something out of either a cough suite or something a dentist use. I think like wormwood or something like that. Right, let's go in. Cheers. I'm sorry, biscuity, malty. There's something hoppy in there as well. Now alt beers are kind of are fairly hoppy, but they're peppery hops in it. Mild little grapefruit piff notes in it, and I'm going in. Cheers. That's quite nice. It's got a bitter finish, very dry bitter finish, almost something itchy on the tongue. It's scratching me. It's something itchy almost. I'm not allergic to anything in this. Like, you know, if you've kind of sung a certain note or something like that, or done something and you've got, whoa, itchy tongue. I don't know if you've ever done that, but you get like the, whoa, what's that? That's weird. Sometimes if you're doing your brushing teeth with one of them electric toothbrushes, you go, whoa, I get itchy nose. It's kind of like that on the tongue. I'll tell you what it is, it's like something spinachy, irony. There's something rocket, maybe. Something along those, maybe thyme or something like that. Something along one of those irony type of mineral sort of herbs in it. There's something like that in the background there. Rocket or thyme or something like spinach along them lines. Maybe even nettle. Not bad. Pretty damn good. One of these things where would you go right out of your way to buy it? There's other beers of similar quality in it. Similar sorts of things. And it is a very nice beer. And it comes in a big bottle, which is nice. And you've got the kind of theatre and everything of popping it. 5.5, so it's sessionable. You can kind of share it out. You're talking, funny enough, talking that size of bottle, and you're talking 500, usual 500 thing that will come in, oh, I don't know, that looks bigger, but that will be in the same size as that. Now, they're holding the same amount, those two. That's weird, isn't it? Isn't that weird? Those two guys there are holding exactly the same amount. How'd you work that out? Huh. Isn't that weird? Both got 500 mil. That looks like 600 or something like that, you know. But, yeah, 500 mil. But I like that, you know, I've got a little resealable top. If you don't want to drink a lot in one go, you can reseal it. Also, if you're a home brewer or something like that, you just sterilise these and you've got lovely little blip and all that, and you can kind of use them again. If you save enough of these, you can use them again and whatever. So they're always nice. And if you've got a brewing mate and you send gear backwards and forwards to each other, you've only got to keep sending the same bottle backwards and forwards, and that, you know. Yeah, I like that. It's nice, but would I go out my way to buy it? I don't know. It's one of those beers you can just describe as it's really quite nice, you know. It's kind of, yeah, it's really quite nice, but I could go and buy other beers down the supermarket, probably for less money, and enjoy them just as much, you know. So, on that premise, I think that is a try and buy it. Maybe like it, you know, try it and buy it. But I think you'd like it, but I don't know whether even to try it and buy it. If the price is right. If the price is right, try it, buy it and like it. Otherwise, it's just a nice beer. It's, you know, very nice, isn't it? As far as I'm, you know, I don't give it marks and all that, because marks, they twist and turn from day to day. You'll have a beer today, and tomorrow it might be a different batch, or will be completely different, or even if it's the same batch, you could have had things today that will alter your taste. You know, even though they've gone off your taste buds, you know, you'll also have different ideas about the beer. You'll have tasted it already. It's like when I tasted the Fuller's Vintage, I was expecting it to be Golden Pride Plus. It was like, oh, this is going to be godlike. And when it wasn't the immortal god that I thought it was going to be, in a way, you know, it was kind of, this is mortal? What? Like that sort of thing. But that's nice. Yeah, it's nice. Would I go and kind of order it from Beers of Europe or wherever again? No, there's too many beers there, you know. So would I say to you guys, order it from Beers of Europe? Nah, there's too many beers there. There's too much to choose from. If it was in a supermarket at the right price, would I buy it? Yeah. Yeah, definitely. Absolutely, definitely. Because I like the top, I like the bottle, and the beer inside is lovely. So if that was like a couple of quid down the supermarket, I'd snap it up. But would I kind of, yeah, would I go online and look for it at 2.50s and 3 quids and whatever else? No. Anyway, folks, I'll see you in the next one. Take care. Don't be late. I will start without you. Biddly boo. Look at that, look. Found a shirt that's actually too long for me. I've got long arms. See you soon. Take care. Bye.
with a man for a world with a man.